Again, bring the legs together. Slowly roll down onto your back, just like you were doing a roll-up. So you're really making the transition smooth. And then flip over onto your tummy. Now you're lying on your stomach. And we're going to start by bringing the elbows in front of you and then push the back up. What I want you to think about here is that you can even leave your arms like the Sphinx, so they're directly in front of you. I want you to go all the way up to your knees and try to lift your pelvis off the floor so that your back is really sucked up. If you feel it in your lower back, you're probably not doing it correctly. You want to exaggerate what's going on in your lower back so it's really sucked up. Keep your tailbone down. Now, this is called the neck roll. You're going to turn your head to the right, and you're going to roll the neck all the way down, lifting your head to the left, and then bringing your head straight ahead. Do it to the left. Turn your head to the left. Roll the chin to the chest. Lift it to the right, and look straight ahead. Repeat. Head to the right. Keep that powerhouse sucked up. Lift it to the left and center. And head to the left. Roll it down. Lift it all the way up to the right, and center the head, stretching the neck. Lie down on your tummy now. Try to do it carefully so you don't strain. And the next exercise is called the single leg kicks. You're going to lie on your tummy with your face down, and you're going to pull your fists into the top of your head with your head down on the top of your head, the tip top. That's it, with fists. And then push the chest up off the floor, looking straight ahead. So your arms are pretty far in front of you there. And your chest is lifted up, but most of your rib cage is on the floor except for your powerhouse is sucked up. This is the single leg kicks now. Here we go. And right leg comes up, kick, kick. Switch legs, kick, kick. Now see if you can keep those knees squeezed together and your buttocks squeezed the whole time. Kick, 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 kick. Right, right. Left, left, keep your buttocks squeezed, push the chest away from the floor the whole time, and keep the stomach up. That's it. There's a little pulse with that back leg. That's enough. Lie on your tummy. Now you're going to bring your arms down by your sides of your body, or you may bring your arms crossed behind the back of your lower back. They are both correct. One of them is a modification. You're going to kick both legs 3 times, and as you kick the legs, of course the powerhouse is sucked up, but when you kick the legs, you try to just barely lift your knees off the floor. Here we go, and kick 1, kick 2, we do it 3 times. Now your legs are going to go back down to the floor again. You're going to arch your back and pinch your shoulder blades together and come up like you're cracking a walnut between the shoulders, and your head is up. Then you bring the arms behind the back again and turn the head, or you may just leave them down by your sides. Again, 3 kicks, 1, 2, and 3. And inhale, bringing that chest up. Try to relax your legs so the legs are still on the floor. And then you come down and exhale and turn the head to the right. Now your left cheek is on the mat. Again, 3 kicks, 1, keep your shoulders relaxed, 2, 3. Now you relax the legs and work the upper body. Chest is back. Try to relax the legs. Come down, turn your head to the left with your right cheek down. Last time. Kick 1, kick 2, and kick 3. Really work that lower body. Now relax the lower body somewhat and come up with the chest. Pinch the shoulder blades together. Come down. Gently turn your head to the side and press the shoulders down. Very nice. Now bring your arms underneath your armpits and center your head so your elbows are bent. You're going to suck the stomach up off the floor and do a push-up to your knees. Remember, in the Pilates push-up, it's all about the powerhouse. You're going to keep your elbows close in towards your body, and you're going to bend the elbows towards the waist on 1, and then push the chest away from the mat on 1. Bend the arms on 2, push the chest, keep your tailbone down and your stomach sucked up. 3rd time, bend your arms and straighten. That's enough. Bend your knees if they're not already bent, and then sit back on your heels for a back stretch. Your arms are going to be long and over your head, and just stretch out your back. So you're reaching from your tailbone all the way to the tips of your fingers, and try to keep your arms straight so your elbows are way out and locked over your head. Then bring the hands down by the feet and slowly roll up, dropping the tailbone down, and let your head float to the surface. Turn around and face the front. Neck pull. Roll up slowly through your back. Sit up straight, turn around and face the front, and lie on your back. Your hands are going to go over your head as if you're going to do the sit-up again, but this becomes the neck pull. You're going to raise your arms to the ceiling just like we were doing the roll-up again. Round the back forward and bring the head up. Reach the arms forward, bring the arms beyond the feet, and then sit up tall with your hands behind the back of your head. Now pull the elbows back, but don't pull the neck forward. Lift the neck right up out of the collarbone. Now lean back slightly, not very much, and then start the powerhouse from the pubic bone all the way up through the powerhouse, up through the breastbone, articulating your spine and rolling back down onto the mat again until your head is there. Repeat, arms to the ceiling, chin to the chest, roll up and reach forward with your head down. Sit up straight with your hands behind the back of your head. Now lift that neck up, pull the neck up out of the collarbone, lean back. Start to round the spine, but articulate each vertebra as you roll down. And the last one, we're going to try this with the hands behind the back of the head. Round up with the hands still behind the back of the head. Round forward. Sit up tall and pull that neck up out of the collarbone. Lean back, feel the neck lifting off the torso. Scoop out the powerhouse, hollow out the powerhouse. Each vertebra, there's a feeling of the tailbone being pulled through the heels as you do that exercise. Next is the shoulder bridge. Bend your knees, put the bottoms of your feet on the floor and your hands down by your sides. Be sure that you are hip width apart with the knees and the feet. Anchor your shoulders and head. Squeeze your buttocks and slowly roll up through the spine one vertebra at a time, pushing each part of your spine up off the mat. Now you're completely up with your buttocks off the mat. We're going to roll back down again slowly. You're going to start by softening the heart. So think of pushing the chest down into the mat until your rib cage touches the mat first, one vertebra at a time, then your waistband, then the back of your butt cheeks, and then finally you totally release the front of the hip flexors. Repeat it again. Squeeze your buttocks, lifting your pelvis off the floor. Peel your spine up off the mat and lift everything up. Hold it there. Now slowly roll down, ribs first, one vertebra at a time. Go slow and always remember that the powerhouse is in and up at all times. And then release the hips. Let's do one more little challenge exercise. This is still the shoulder bridge. Squeeze your buttocks, roll up through the spine, push all the way up, keeping it out of the neck. Reach the fingertips towards your heels. Take your right leg off the mat and straighten your right leg up to the ceiling, flexing your right foot. Now bring your right leg down until it touches the knee of the left leg. And then bring it back up and point your toe. Bring your leg down with a flex until your knees are touching. And then kick your leg back up again. One more. Bring the leg down. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Keep your pelvis up and bring the leg up. Switch legs. Let's do that on the left side, left leg up. Flex your left foot, reach it down, almost like you're touching your knees together, and then bring your legs up. And flex it and reach it down, long, 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 long from the hip, and then point your toe and lift it up. And flex it down. You're not actually going to touch your knees together, but you're lengthening it. And then lift your leg back up. Put your foot down, keep your legs hip width apart, and then slowly roll down. Ribs, middle back, lower back, hip flexors, and release the hips. Now sit up. The next exercise is the spine twist. Your legs will be straight in front of you. They're going to be together. If you are having difficulty sitting up in the back, then you're going to bend your knees again like we did in the spine stretch forward and the saw. You may bend your knees slightly. Still keep your feet flexed if you can though. Bring your arms out to the side. Now squeeze the thighs together and keep it tight. Now sit up tall with your arms to the side. Twist your body to the right. Stop with your arms directly out to the side. Don't let your left arm move too far. And turn your head further than your torso. And then bring the arms back to the front again, really up. Twist to the left. Turn your head a little further than the torso. Don't move your legs. And come back to the center. Now we're going to add a little pulse to this. Keep your back really tall. And twist. Right, right, center. Twist. Pulse, pulse. Now let's breathe deeper. Inhale, twist right. Exhale, center. Inhale, twist left. Don't move. your legs. Now let's switch the breathing. Exhale on the twist and inhale on the center. And exhale, don't shrink, and inhale on the center. Exhale, twist, inhale, center. Exhale, twisting, and inhale, center. You should try to keep your feet flexed the whole time on that exercise, your knees together and as tall as you can in your back. Careful the shoulders don't slide up. Thank you. Let's go on to side kicks.